The preamble is there to establish why there is a constitution in the first place, which is created to protect the citizens. And thus, the Constitution of the United States of America was ratified on June 21st, 1788.
Political rhetoric.
For my people.
The more we learn about who we are and how we got here, the more we can mobilize.
Let's get to it. Three articles. You know, the first described the structure of the legislative branch.
Article 1, Section 1 establishes the name of the legislatures, which we know as the Congress. Section 2 defines the House of Representatives. Section 3 defines the Senate. Section 4 says each state may establish its own methods of electing members of Congress, and requires that the Congress meet at least once a year. Section 5, Congress must have a minimum number of members present in order to meet, and that it may set fines for members who don't show up. So no call, no show, pay up.
Just what America needs, another paid holiday and a bunch of government workers being paid to go out and work. I assume our folks on, our colleagues on the other side, on their campaign.
Section 6 states the Congress will be paid and cannot hold any other governmental office.
Hear what Captain Planet has to say.
The power is yours.
Section 7 determines how a bill becomes a law.
And you wake one morning just to find your courage gone.
But just know that feeling only lasts a little while.
He's on down the road.
Section 8 lists the specific powers ranging from the power to create an army, create courts, regulate commerce between the states,
federal workers who are going to homeless shelters to get food.
Well, I know they are, and I don't really quite understand why. There's no real reason why they shouldn't be able to get a loan against it.
Don't boo, vote.
Declare war and raise money.
Did you and your friends have fun?
Section 9 limits the Congress, such as no law can give preference to one state over the other.
Nothing short of apocalyptic. 80% of New Orleans, including much of downtown, is underwater. People who could least afford it have lost the most. They can't even pick up dead bodies. There is nowhere to put them. And people who now have nothing and no place to go swear they've rode out their last hurricane.
No money can be taken from the treasury, and no title of nobility will ever be established by the government. Section 10, the states cannot make their own money, tax goods from other states, declare war, or have their own navies.
The second article described the structure of the executive branch, which is the president, and George Washington was elected the first president. He was the general that led the American Revolutionary Wars.
Article 2, Section 1 establishes the office of the president and vice president. Section 2 states that the president is the commander-in-chief of the armed forces and the National Guard of all states.
Trust, we all feel the same way.
He has a cabinet that also aid him.
Here's a new bill that you must read immediately. It lowers taxes for only Republicans.
Can Fox News read it and I'll watch what they say?
No, you have to read it.
He is dead in the water if he doesn't build that wall. Dead, dead, dead.
Or they're manipulated and listen to delusional-ass conservatives.
The Democrat Party and the media.
He can pardon criminals, create treaties with other nations.
You better start running, running. Babylon boy, them are coming, coming, yeah. You better start running, running. Babylon is coming. Babylon, get your lips up, we. Have we just because I walk this way. Babylon get jealous of we, of we.
And pick judges and other governmental officials with the approval of the Senate.
See that your 5 minutes is up, and so I'm...
Attorney General, we're not joking here. And your humor is not acceptable.
We're all trying to figure out, who are you? Where did you come from? And how the heck did you become the head of the Department of Justice? So hopefully you can help me work through this confusion.
All right, well, Congressman, not...
Mr. Whitaker, that was a statement, not a question.
Section 3, the duties include the State of the Union address.
You can be a child.
Got it!
And make sure laws are carried out. And make suggestions to Congress.
Thank you, Congress, for spending 8 years wishing you could replace me with a Republican. Or, to put it another way, how do you like me now?
So I'm going to be signing a national emergency. And it's been signed many times before. It's been signed by other presidents. There's rarely been a problem. They sign it. Nobody cares. I guess they weren't very exciting.
The president addresses the nation tonight. He'll be laying out the facts to the American people of what is a genuine humanitarian and security crisis at our southern border. We have a crisis.
But nobody cares. They sign it for far less important things in some cases, in many cases.
Section 4 explains the impeachment of a president.
The third article, the judicial branch.
Article 3, Section 1, establishes the Supreme Court, the highest court in the United States.
Supreme Court Justice Ivanka takes Ruth Bader Ginsburg's seat on the bench.
They serve for as long as they're on good behavior, a.k.a. for life.
For life? For life?
God, this is horrible. This was supposed to last me the whole 4 years.
Check and balance. So there was no branch that was, powerful than the other. But there was one thing that was irking certain rich, wealthy people. They were fighting against the possibility of radicalism, afraid that there would be more common folk who would vote in more common folk to these elected offices, which you would think would be the point of elections, is to elect people that represent and look like the people.
An unbelievable tape. They'll be coming tonight. And I think we're going to serve McDonald's, Wendy's, and Burger King's with some pizza. I really mean it. It'll be interesting. And I would think that's their favorite food.
Who can speak on behalf of the people. But because they feared this, they didn't want common folk to be Congress, let alone the President of the United States. So to fight against this, senators were elected by state legislators. People that make the law, or lawyer, people just high up, high rich people. Like,
you show is ugly.
Wasn't us, mind you, we're still slaves, so we have no say so in it.
Ew.
Ew, get off of me. Ugh, I'm F.
And the poor people don't either.
How does that feel?
But that's the whole tragic point, my friends. What would I do?
They were supposed to be leading citizens, great role models who legislators voted in. A lot about senators, right? That part.
I really don't think Donald Trump's a conservative. I think he's a fake, and absolutely, I'm with the president on that.
Another thing to stop common folk from, you know, being elected was the Electoral College. Electing a president who did not win the popular vote. Voting a president who did not win the popular vote. The electors were prominent, educated men of property. Who would seem fit to elect the president.
No, huh?
Pretty much no, keeping it in the family again, which many people hate today and hated back then.
From now on, you'll be history.
You'll be history.
And we will glorify your name.
Oh, and by the way, I ain't learned none of this shit in school. And if I did, don't remember.